Jim Harris, the executive director of the Santa Monica Pier Corporation. And I've been on the pier actually for 33 years. And in all that time, I've not always been the executive director, of course. I actually started out as a bartender in 1989 at an old restaurant here called the Boathouse. And back in those days, I got to hear wonderful stories of what the pier was like, and I just fell in love with it. And I've had all sorts of odd jobs ever since, not the least of which is the pier's historian. I literally wrote the book about the pier. It's called Santa Monica Pier, A Century on the Last Great Pleasure Pier. It's been an honor to be a part of the pier's history and to share the pier's history like I've been able to do. It's been a yacht harbor. It's had a great ballroom on it, the largest ballroom in the world. It's all sorts of really interesting activities. But it really all comes down to being this wonderful outdoor venue that anybody can come and have their own style of enjoyment for free. For one thing, there is no cover charge to enter the pier ever. You can walk on it for free anytime you want. You can fish off of the end of it for free. But you don't have to have a fishing license to fish off of the pier. And there are very few places in the world like that where you don't have to have a license. You can enjoy the street performers here. We have all sorts of free events throughout the year. We have a locals night, a once a month locals night, which is Santa Monicans putting on entertainment for Santa Monicans, and anyone else can come and enjoy, of course. So that's a really fun night, and that's on the third Thursday of every month, and we're really having fun with that program. Santa Monica is a big arts community anyway, and so that's what this locals night is really all about, is the local arts organizations and the schools showing off what they have to offer. We've had wonderful ballet, folklorico dancing, and Indian dancing. We've had visual arts, student bands, you know, really fantastic things. And the more that we can foster and share that, the better. One of the reasons that we created Locals Night is because locals had felt for years pushed away by all the crowds. And that was unfortunate. Just recently, we created Locals Night with the concept of, you know, we're putting this night together for you to come and enjoy your pier. So we invite them down, and the comments that we received right from the beginning were, I am so glad you're doing this. You know, I had forgotten what the pier was like. I'd forgotten the good things about the pier, and I get to see my neighbors. And for us, having this be a post-COVID event, when everybody's been cooped up for the past 2 years and not seeing their neighbor, for them to come see their neighbor now, that's really special. And we're doing it right here at the pier. We just had the LA Opera doing their annual live simulcast. They put up a big screen and people can sit and watch a performance of LA Opera for free under the stars. And that's been a really great event for the past many years. We're very famous for our concerts. For 35 years, we had one of the most popular free concert series in the world, right here on the Santa Monica Pier. It was called the Twilight Concert Series. Santa Monica is a very busy city. Los Angeles is one of the busiest places in the world. But all you have to do is take a few steps onto the pier, and that's behind you. And I think that's really what makes the pier the most special, is that it's an escape. It's within the city, but it's an escape from the city. That is one of the great things about the crowds that visit here, is it is often grandparents bringing their grandchildren, especially to the merry-go-round, parents bringing their children and sharing stories of when their parents brought them. We hear those stories all the time. But that's something I think that applies to the entire pier, is it's something that one generation can share with the next. When you visit the pier, don't just go to one place. You may have the one reason that you really want to visit it, but try to walk the length of the pier and see what else you can experience, because you know, it's 1,600 feet long, and that 1,600 feet has a lot to offer, a lot of different experiences that you wouldn't be expecting when you come down here, but you'll be much rewarded for by the time you leave.